Desiree Levertu. I'm the Director of Choral and Vocal Activities here at the college. It's my pleasure tonight to introduce the recital to you. I still remember Yuri's last percussion recital with amazement and fondness. I'm super excited about tonight, as I'm sure you are also. She's a wonderful teacher here for us, teaching percussion at Oxy. And I also love that she's joined by a wonderful pianist about town, Mitsuko, also one of my favorite collaborative artists to work with. So it's such a great combination. I'd like to invite you to make sure your phones are off, or at the very least, very silent, please, because it is a disturbance, of course, for our performances. We are being live streamed, and so we ask that you not leave between, you know, while people are playing. Just wait till things are finished and whatnot, and don't let your phones go off. So, anyway, without further ado, here I am.
Thank you. She wrote this piece when she moved to Santa Barbara from Paris, and she was inspired by all these Southern Californian trees, which I relate a lot because I moved from Japan first to Northern California, and then when I came to LA, those are the trees that I noticed. So it had a great, you know, place in my heart to play that piece. And also I would like to, you know, introduce you to this brand new 5.5 octave marimba that Occidental had acquired. So it was just kind of a perfect combination for me to present this piece and open the recital with this piece. So the next piece I'm going to play, so I'm gonna kind of move around and talk at the same time. A little casual, that's okay. I have my water because I'll get thirsty. So the next piece I'm going to play is called Negative Magic by a composer named Tanya Koh. I was very inspired by this piece also because she really took the sound of the drum out of its, you know, standard kind of expectations that we, you know, would think what a snare drum sounds. So the instruction is to actually change the tuning of the drum head. We usually have it pretty tight, so the sticks kind of bounce around. So she asks you to loosen everything, so it's pretty loose right now. And then, depending on the place of the screw, you turn it just a little bit. Some of them are really loose. So she really explored the sound of this one drum. And if you're my student, you probably know that I spend a lot of time, you know, in lessons doing snare drum because it's such a simple thing, but there's a lot we can do. So I hope you enjoy this piece. It's gonna be different. and then you also notice that this is amplified. So you'll hear a little bit of echo, but it's, I think it's very interesting use of the drum. So here is Negative Magic by Tanya Koh. Thank you. so old, written in the 20th century. This piece has become pretty standardized repertoire in the multiple percussion setting. That's what we call it when we mix drums and then put it all as one set. This piece is really interesting. He has a lot of things side by side. As you can see, there are pairs of drums. Sometimes there are rhythms or meter, two different meters going on at the same time. So you will see my right hand keeping a steady pulse, while my left hand is also keeping a steady pulse, but at a different time. And then they kind of all merge together. I really enjoy playing this piece. He gives you a lot of freedom. I forgot my pace runner. He gives you a lot of freedom about how to perform this piece. So sometimes you might repeat a section once. Sometimes you might repeat it four times. So every time you play, it's a little bit different, but it's within the rules that he's written on the piece of music. So it's really enjoyable. And in this little room, it's gonna be a little bit on the loud side of it. So just to warn you, I won't be offended if you cover your ears time to time. It's okay. Thank you. Thank you. So glad we are able to share live music again. It's just so meaningful. The first concert I went after the shutdown, before this concert started, I was crying just because I was so happy. Anyway, this last piece is called China West Suite by Chen Yi. And there are four movements in this piece, and each movement is based on a different folk tune from regions around China. So there's a, I think you can see it in the program note if you're here. She picked different group of people and listened to their music, and that inspiration from that, and then wrote this piece. It was originally written for two pianos, and she has arranged it to be played on the piano and a marimba. So it's really a duet between the two of us. It's not like she's gonna accompany my soloistic playing, but I really enjoy chamber music. I it's like why I play music is so I can play music with people. So I'm really glad she's able to join us. Let me get my mallet. Thank you. Thank you.